A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 31st October, on the front page you have terror in Kashmir, a big problem. So this is what the members of European Parliament, the delegation which visited Srinagar, said. They said terrorism is a severe problem in Kashmir and named Pakistan as its source. They felt India's decision to revoke provisions of Article 370 that gave special status to Jammu and Kashmir was an internal issue. Also, this is Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh become union territories. So, bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories comes into effect as such now at midnight of 31st October 2019, as soon as the date commences. And this is High Court quashes cow smuggling case against Pehlu Khan. So, animals were purchased for dairy farming is what has been established. So, the Rajasthan High Court has quashed this cow smuggling case registered against Haryana dairy farmer Pehlu Khan, who was allegedly lynched by a mob of cow vigilance in 2017. So, this is actually Pehlu Khan has been lynched to death by a cow vigilant mob. And a case was registered against Pehlu Khan himself too for smuggling cows. So this case has now been quashed. It was said that he had purchased the cow for dairy farming. The case of lynching is still going on. It had come in news that all the accused had been acquitted. So now the case is going in appeal as such too. And this is a separate case on cow smuggling, which has been quashed. Then we can skip this news. We have been discussing about Delhi's pollution. It's almost in news every day, which need not be accumulated, such news items. Then this is also regarding Justice Bobde. He gives his viewpoint here that all forms of authority are under challenge, in the sense not that authority has been diluted, or power has been undermined as such, but then children challenge the authority of their parents, school's authority is challenged, parliament's authority is being challenged by the people, and judiciary is also being challenged. So in that sense he says that all forms of authority are under challenge. On page 9 you have NPCIL acknowledges malware attack at Kudankulam plant. So this is, yesterday we saw in news how Kudankulam authorities had said there was no malware attack when a cyber expert had claimed on Twitter that the compromise has taken place here. There are concerns raised. So now NPCIL, Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited, has confirmed that a malware had indeed infected the system at Kudankulam nuclear power plant. So this is what has been stated. It was earlier said that plant could not be accessed by anyone outside, as they are very well isolated. So identification of malware in NPCIL system is correct has been stated now. The matter was conveyed to CERT-IN, that is Computer Emergency Response Team of India, and it was in September 2019 when it was noticed. And matter was investigated. Investigation has revealed that the infected computer belonged to a user who was connected in the internet connected network used for administrative purposes. So this was the reason, you can see. Stating that the system was isolated from critical internal network, he said that the networks were being continuously monitored. But the plant systems are not infected. This cyber intrusion actually is a serious cause of concern. So it's called D-track malware, which can be used as a remote administrator control. So this infected the Kudankulam nuclear power plant. So now thorough investigation would take place how this has come into being. Also, National Cyber Security Coordinator, as such, was notified that this breach is, this intrusion is a casus belli, which is a provocation for war in the Indian cyberspace. This is what the tweet by the cyber security expert had said. And here you have submarine propulsion system test a success. So indigenous air independent propulsion system to enhance the endurance of conventional submarines has been developed by DRDO. It is a milestone which has been reached by this successful operation of this land-based prototype. So all Scorpene submarines of Indian Navy are planned to be equipped with air independent propulsion module. On the editorial page, the first editorial is visiting Kashmir. So this says the center must change the situation in Kashmir and not just the global perception of it. So this is the context of MEP visit, members of European Parliament visit to Jammu and Kashmir. And this is test by night. So this is the innovation which is inevitable in the longest and oldest of cricket's many formats, the test cricket. So it's a 5-day tenure. So so to make it seemingly worse, these long winding contests can also throw up a draw. So this makes tests as such, you know, in this time of instant gratification, you know, too long for viewers. So there is a dip in spectator attendance also. Abridged variants are there, like one day internationals and 2020. So, but still tests have survived. So this is regarding test cricket. But it says innovation is inevitable. And the lead article is upholding the ideas of fairness and rectitude. So this says bright line recusal rules demand that a judge looks not to his moral sense but considers what a reasonable person thinks. So this is regarding the recusal which is being demanded from the judge as such. And he refuses, Judge Arun, Justice Arun Mishra, he refuses to recuse himself from the case. We have discussed about this in quite detail. It had been prominently news about land acquisition case, if you remember. The Supreme Court's 3-judge bench had given a verdict. And then recently, the 3-judge bench led by this Justice Arun Mishra gave a verdict which went against the earlier Supreme Court judgment. So 3-judge bench overruling another 3-judge bench judgment is against judicial rules. So now a larger bench is being set up to look into that, and that is also chaired by Justice Arun Mishra himself, in which he will rule whether his judgment given earlier is to be upheld or not. So demand is that he should recuse himself from the case, but he refuses. He says in his personal capacity is nothing of his personal capacity associated. And this is internationalizing the Kashmir issue. So this is in the context of the members of European Parliament visit. So it says after the visit by MPs of European Union to Delhi, India's rejection of mediation will seem contradictory. So we don't want outside intervention in the Kashmir issue, and we call outsiders to look at the matter. So that contradiction is highlighted here. On the op-ed page you have building a stronger investment base. So Tamil Nadu government, this article says, should match its outreach activities with speedy decision making. So Amazon has its establishment here. So it wants to make Tamil Nadu into a strong investment base. So government should have speedy decision making too, is what this article says. And this is free trade over fair trade. So it is said fair trade is often an excuse to raise more protectionist barriers to serve domestic special interest groups. So free trade is then, you know, brought down by fair trade. That to be fair, then protectionist barriers are brought in. So this issue is covered here in US-China trade war context as such too. And here you have still a developing country. So it says India's publicity drive about development can come back to bite it at WTO, World Trade Organization. So you say that we are developing and, you know, we have made many advancements, and we still use the term developing for yourself with other developing countries. So that will be your contradiction, which is detailed out here. Because at WTO, World Trade Organization, developed and developing countries are separately treated. On page 12, you have Farooq's detention extended for 3 months. So, former Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister faces 27 charges under Public Safety Act, and his detention has been extended to 3 months furthermore. He has been detained since August 5. And here you have Merkel may raise Kashmir with Modi. So, this is former German Chancellor as such, Angela Merkel. So, Kashmir may come up for discussion during German Chancellor Angela Merkel's November 1 to 3 visit to India. So she's again German Chancellor, and she would raise this issue. Then on page 13 you have, why West Bengal's Murshidabad shivers in Kashmir's chilling trail of blood? So terrorists are now targeting migrant workers from Murshidabad town of West Bengal. They are engaged as masons, carpenters, agricultural laborers in Kashmir Valley. And this is ahead of summit, India's stand on RCEP unclear. So we have been discussing about RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement, which has been negotiated among 16 nations. That is in 10 ASEAN members, Association of Southeast Asian Nations, and the 6 nations with which ASEAN has FTA, which includes India, China, Australia, New Zealand, Japan, and South Korea. So India's stand is still unclear, even on e-commerce, etc., on data, whether data localization can be allowed or not, because RCEP does not amount data localization. So India has differing viewpoints. On international page, again, you have news regarding impeachment of President Donald Trump, which comes in news every day. So we don't need to follow it regularly, but we'll see the gist of the news later. We have already discussed it too earlier. This is Chile pulls out from hosting climate and trade summits. So this is the South American nation, Chile. So it is rocked by protests, and government says focus is on restoring order. So it has pulled out as host for key UN climate change meeting and major Asia Pacific trade summit in 2019. And this is, will Hariri's resignation end Lebanon's crisis? So Lebanon's Prime Minister Saad al-Hariri announced his resignation after two weeks of street protests. So it were violent protests between political factions which were going on. So he says he had hit a dead end and he quit. But the question is, will his resignation end Lebanon's crisis? The protests were going on because the government proposed to impose $6 monthly tax on WhatsApp users to raise funds. Government withdrew the proposal as such too, but protesters never left the streets. They demand end to corruption and resignation of country's powerful elite, with more and more people joining them. So this is the demand being made. Below you have, US House recognizes Armenian genocide. So Armenia rejoiced, but Turkey was furious after US House of Representatives passed a historic resolution recognizing mass killing of Armenians a century ago as genocide. So this was Turkey, which is accused of genocide here. Turkey strongly denies these accusations of genocide and says that both Armenians and Turks died as a result of the First World War. And here you have over 22,000 Indians seeking asylum in US. So these are 22,000, including 7,000 women who have applied for asylum in US since 2014. Reasons being unemployment or intolerance in or both in India. And this is WhatsApp sues Israeli firm for hacking 1,400 users. So this is a cyber surveillance firm from Israel, NSO Group. So this group targeted activists, journalists, and their families. So WhatsApp has now sued this organization, claiming that the company's spy technology was used on the popular messaging service in a wide-ranging campaign targeting journalists and human rights activists. On business page, you have here, NIRVIC scheme may give fillip to export credit. So, Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India is optimistic that the NIRVIC scheme announced by the Union government recently would give a fillip to export lending and insurance cover for export credits. So, this is the scheme announced. So, currently the coverage which is given by banks to, given to banks by the Export Credit Guarantee Council is 60%. It is said under the NIRVIC scheme, it will provide 90% cover. So additional outgo, if any, due to the enhanced cover, it is said will be supported by the government, and the scheme would be valid for 5 years. So that is it. These are the important headlines. There's no news on the last page. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashr.com. Thank you.